Hello and welcome everyone. In this video, I'll explain about the application of symmetry. One of the applications, there are plenty of applications for symmetry. Most of these are qualitative applications. We cannot say there is a quantitative application for symmetry. Just as suppose if I choose a molecule, I can say whether the molecule is polar or whether the molecule is non-polar qualitatively. But once if the molecule is polar, I just cannot measure how much dipole moment is present in it with the help of symmetry. For that reason, we say symmetry gives qualitative information but not quantitative information. How much magnitude is present, we cannot say. But whether it is present or not, we can say. Not just dipole moment, even if I choose some molecule, I can say whether the molecule is optically active or not just by looking at the symmetry elements or the point group of the given molecule. Plenty of applications of symmetry are there. When you relate symmetry with group theory, where the character tables are given, once you get deeper into the character tables, you get the information about the spectroscopic properties of a given molecule, hybridization of the central metal atom or the central ion. You can also get what is the symmetry of the individual orbital of that particular molecule, individual orbital of that particular central atom. Every information you can get it just from character table of group theory, which is correlated to symmetry. But this video is restricted only to one of these applications, and the application is we are trying to relate symmetry with dipole moment, and we are going to say whether the given molecule is polar or whether it is non-polar. To understand this concept, let's understand about the three spatial coordinates. Consider this to be the z, x pointing towards you, y towards your right hand side. Opposite are the minus coordinates. If this is plus x, away will be minus x. Above is plus z, below is minus z. And if this is plus y towards your right, minus y is towards your left. First of all, I'll tell you the symmetry criteria, then you will very easily understand whether the given molecule has dipole moment or not. At the end, I'll simply give you some logics, or just you can remember one point group. By remembering that point group, you can say whether that is polar or a non-polar molecule. Now try to understand the concept. If there is any symmetry element or group of elements, you can choose one symmetry element or you may choose some group of elements. If any element or group of elements, when they exchange all the opposite coordinates, then we say that the molecule is non-polar. So simple is the criteria, but there is an in-depth understanding in it. I'm just repeating this point again. Whenever there is one symmetry element or there could be group of symmetry elements which can exchange all the opposite coordinates, z with minus z, if these two get exchanged, x with minus x, and y with minus y, when all the opposite coordinates exchange, then molecule will be non-polar. But the chosen symmetry element or group of symmetry elements, if they are not able to exchange even one coordinate, molecule will be polar, and polarity will exist in that direction or in that corresponding plane. What do I mean by this? I'll just explain you. But try to understand the criteria. If all the opposite coordinates exchange, molecule will be non-polar. Even if one coordinate do not exchange, molecule will have some polarity. Let me choose the symmetry elements and let's check for the criteria. The first symmetry element that I'm choosing is a CN along Z. Conventionally, we start with Z. You can also choose along Y, you can also choose along X. Supposing that I am choosing CN along Z axis, so this is my rotational axis, you just check for the plus X minus X, plus Y minus Y, what is happening to them you see. Now as I am rotating, plus X is exchanging with minus X. As I do a complete rotation, at one point plus and minus will get exchanged. In a similar way, if this is plus Y minus Y, as I rotate by 360 degree, at one point plus and minus will exchange, you check. So plus y minus y are being exchanged, plus x minus x are being exchanged, but to whatever angle that I rotate, you can check plus z is in plus z is at minus z, plus z minus z are not exchanging. It means the symmetry element rotation is not able to exchange all the opposite coordinates. Therefore, such a molecule will have some polarity. A molecule that has only rotational axis will have some polarity, and that polarity will be in the direction of the unexchanged coordinate. Let me give you the point. If there is only a rotational axis within the molecule, say Cn along Z, which coordinates are being shifted? X is being shifted with minus X, Y is being shifted with minus Y, or you can say exchanged. While rotating, they are being exchanged. Not X is exchanging with Y, but X is exchanging with minus X, Y is exchanging with minus Y. But which coordinate is unshifted? Z is unshifted. Z is not exchanging with minus Z. Z is unshifted. Now, even if one of them is unshifted, molecule will be polar. So what is the conclusion means? In any molecule, if there is only rotational axis, then the molecule has to be polar. Or any molecule that belong to CN point group, where n could be 1 or greater than 1, any molecule that belong to CN point group has to be polar, where n could be 1 or greater than 1. Most important point. In a similar way, you can also pass through Y, or you can also pass through X. If there is only one rotational axis, we say the molecule will be polar. Hydrogen peroxide, open book shaped hydrogen peroxide, has C2 symmetry element. It belongs to C2 point group. There is no other symmetry element in it. Therefore, open book shaped hydrogen peroxide has to be polar. That is how we conclude. Let me take another symmetry element. I'm taking Cn plus I'm taking other rotational axis nc2s perpendicular to cnz. It means I'm taking two different rotational axes. One is the principal axis, the remaining are the subsidiary or the secondary axis that are perpendicular to the principal axis. What is happening? Let's check. I'm first of all passing the principal axis. When I pass the principal axis, you look at X, you look at Y. They are exchanging with their opposite coordinates as I rotate. I'm just taking the reference of X. Now as I rotate, it has come into minus X. It means plus and minus are being exchanged. Okay? Y and minus Y are being exchanged. But Z will remain. Z is not exchanging with minus Z. Later on, we have C2's perpendicular to this principal axis. So if this is a C2, perpendicular to it could be any C2, any number. If I am just trying to take this C2 perpendicular to the principal axis, look at Z. This is a C2 perpendicular to the principal axis. So when I pass perpendicular C2s, even Z is being exchanged with its opposite coordinate. So the combination of these two, combination of Cn along Z is exchanging X and Y, followed by perpendicular C2 is also exchanging Z. It means all the three coordinates are being exchanged. When all the three coordinates exchange, molecule has to be non-polar, right? With respect to Cn, X and Y get exchanged. With respect to perpendicular C2s, Z is also getting exchanged. Which coordinate is unshifted? No. Every coordinate is being shifted. Then will it be polar? Such a molecule will be non-polar. Conclusion is, you have Cn and nc2s perpendicular to it, that simply mean wherever you have D, wherever you have D, definitely the molecule will be non-polar. So where do we have D? In Dn we have D, in Dnh point group we have D, in Dnd point group also we have D. It means we have Cn perpendicular C2s, Cn perpendicular C2s, Cn perpendicular C2s. So any molecule belonging to these point groups will be non-polar. That is the simple conclusion. I have completed the rotations. Now let's come to the sigma plane. If I go towards molecules with special symmetry, such as tetrahedra, octahedra, cube, icosahedra, dodecahedra, they have multiple higher order rotational axes. Supposing that I choose an octahedra. For that octahedra, just imagine that this is an octahedra. it has multiple higher order rotational axes, more than one principal axis. This is 1C4, 2nd C4, 3rd C4. If this is 1C4, the other C4 is perpendicular to it. 3rd C4 is also perpendicular. So one is perpendicular to the other, and you will not have any polarity in octahedra because there are multiple higher order rotational axes. Same is the case with tetrahedra, and same is the case with icosahedra and their conjugates. So whether I choose tetrahedra, octahedra, cube, icosahedra or dodecahedra, they will not have any polarity. Anyway, coming to the sigma now. If I can have only sigma, now let me just choose the coordinates again, x, y and z. If I am trying to pass a plane, imagine let me pass an xz plane. That plane is passing through two coordinates, and from whichever coordinate the plane is passing from, those coordinates will never exchange, remaining coordinate will exchange. So if I try to pass this plane, y will exchange with minus y, but z will remain there, it will not exchange with minus z, x cannot exchange with minus x. So these two coordinates will remain in their position. Therefore polarity will exist, and that polarity will be in this plane. Okay. Suppose if I pass yz plane, again this yz plane is passing through z and y, they remain in their position, but x will exchange with the opposite coordinate. If I pass xy, z will exchange with the opposite coordinate. So any plane that I am passing will pass through two coordinates which do not get exchanged, whereas the third coordinate get exchanged. It means there will be polarity, and that polarity will lie in the plane. Sigma, if I am choosing, suppose if I start with sigma xy, if the sigma is passing through x and y, that x and y will not undergo any shift. So the coordinates unshifted will be x and y, but z will undergo a shift. I need not name it as a vertical plane or a horizontal plane, okay. Suppose I take sigma xz, then y will shift, but x and z do not shift. Or if I take yz, x will shift, y and z do not shift. Since these are not shifting, definitely there will be some polarity. So all the three mean the same. They simply mean if in a molecule there is only a plane, then such a molecule will be polar, right? So let me give you a point group which is having only a plane. CS is a point group that has only plane, nothing else. Therefore any molecule that belongs to CS has to be polar. You take a phenol molecule, phenol is polar. Why it is polar? Because it belongs to CS. Why it is polar means the explanation comes from here. Since there is only a plane, and a plane cannot exchange all the opposite coordinates, it is not able to exchange two coordinates. Therefore, such a molecule will be polar. This is about an individual symmetry element called as a plane. Now let me take combinations. First we started with rotation and a combination with C2s. Then I have taken a plane. Now let's take combinations of the planes. Combination of the planes means let me combine it with some other symmetry elements. Suppose I may choose a Cn plus sigma xz, or I may choose a Cn plus sigma yz. Let me choose these planes. Also let me choose Cn plus sigma xy. There is a qualitative difference between this set of planes and this plane. What is the qualitative difference? You check. This is a rotational axis along z, and if the plane has that coordinate, this will be a vertical plane. This is a Cn along z, and plane has that coordinate, therefore this is also a vertical plane. Cn along z, but that z coordinate is not in the plane, therefore this has to be a horizontal plane. In brackets I am writing it as a horizontal plane, whereas this is a vertical plane and a vertical plane. So in simple terminology, the first one is a combination of a rotation and a vertical plane, rotation and a vertical plane, rotation and a horizontal plane. When I am passing Cn along z, in the previous case we have seen x is undergoing a shift, y is also undergoing a shift, but z is not undergoing any shift. Z is unshifted. You can check. Suppose if this is the coordinate, now I am just rotating it. As I rotate, you can check the z, it is unshifted with minus z. It is there in its position. Later on, I am trying to pass a plane which is parallel to the principal axis, which you call it as a vertical plane. That could be sigma xz or that could be sigma yz. So let me pass xz or yz. You can still check. If I am passing xz, y is being exchanged. Okay, if I am passing yz, x is being exchanged, but z is still remaining in its position. So the combination of these two symmetry elements, cn with sigma xz, cn with sigma yz, the combination is not able to exchange all the three coordinates. Still one coordinate is left unchanged. Therefore, any molecule which has combination of cn and sigma v will be polar. Or any molecule that belong to cnv, c infinity v, they should be polar. Simple terminology. Water molecule is polar because it belongs to C2V point group. Pyridine is polar. Formaldehyde is polar because they belong to CNV point group where N is 2. CNZ with a horizontal plane. Now this is the coordinate system. I rotate. As I rotate, X is being exchanged, Y is also being exchanged with its opposite coordinate. Z is not getting exchanged. Later on, I am taking a horizontal plane. Combination is a horizontal plane. When I am taking a horizontal plane, that plane is passing through x and y, which do not get exchanged, but z is being exchanged with minus z. So rotation is exchanging x and y, followed by a plane perpendicular is exchanging z also. Combination of these two symmetry elements, it is exchanging all the opposite coordinates. So x and y get exchanged with respect to rotation, and z is also getting exchanged due to horizontal plane. Which coordinate is unshifted? Every coordinate is being shifted. So the molecule will be non-polar. How to understand this? Wherever you have CN combined with a sigma H, all such point groups will be non-polar. CNH. We have CN and a sigma H. Any point group that has SN in it, all such molecules will be non-polar. We have taken rotation and also a plane. Now what I will do is, I will just take an inversion. I am just taking an inversion. When I choose an inversion, what inversion does is, from the point called as center of gravity, from that center of gravity, all the opposite identical points get exchanged once I pass inversion. So having said that, plus z will exchange with minus z, plus x with minus x, plus y with minus y, all the opposite coordinates will exchange when I pass inversion. Since all the coordinates are being exchanged, any molecule that has inversion will be non-polar. So such a molecule will not be polar, instead it will be non-polar. So where do you find inversion means? Inversion can be found in C2H, it could be found in some D and D point groups where N is odd, D3D, D5D and so on. Or it is also found in octahedra, icosahedra. So wherever you find inversion, all such molecules will be non-polar. Hope you are getting it. I choose PtCl4 2 minus, tetrachloroplatinate. Is it polar or non-polar? Then I work out its point group that belong to D4H. There is D in it. D means there is a CN and perpendicular C2. C4 and 4C2 is perpendicular to it. Therefore, it has to be non-polar. Or you go for the another element. There is also S2 in it. Therefore, it should be non-polar. Or there is inversion in it. Therefore, it has to be non-polar. So one criteria is enough to decide whether a given molecule is polar or not. And as I said, molecules with special symmetry anyway, they are non-polar. So let me give you a conclusion. C1, CN, where N is greater than 1, CS, CNV and C infinity V. N could also be imagined as infinity, but I am giving it as a separate point group. Any molecule that belongs to C1, CN, where N is greater than 1, CS, CNV and C infinity V are polar. Remaining molecules are non-polar. This is a very strong criteria to decide whether the given molecule is polar or not and whether it is having some dipole moment or not. Finally, I will just repeat the criteria, symmetry criteria for dipole moment. Any symmetry element, or if I choose group of elements, if they are able to exchange all the opposite coordinates, then the molecule will not have polarity. Even if one coordinate is unexchanged, then the molecule will have some polarity in that direction or in that plane. Okay, thank you.